Thank you for the introduction. Back. Okay, first of all, I would like to thank the opportunity in the name of, on behalf of the other co-authors to share our work with you. We'll talk about the choriocapillaries, it's the second talk on this board. We know that OCT angiography has enabled us to get very good quality images of high definition of the choriocapillaries, and that these images, after special thresholding methods, are reminiscent of the choriocapillaries observed on in vivo. And an interesting property of these binary images is that they enable us to quantify the characteristics of the choriocapillaries. We know that the choriocapillaries, due to its complex dynamics, can be compared to a complex system, being the flow voids, the principal agents of this system, and they are very different in animal models, in both health and in disease. And so, first of all, a basic thing to characterize a complex system is to characterize its constituents and its agents, to measure them, and to plot its distribution to foresee what's happening in our system. And Dr. Spade has talked about it, the difference between the additive systems and the multiplicative systems. We know that in the additive systems, the shape reveals information about the dynamics and how. The new events converge always to the mean. And by contrast, the multiplicative systems, the different events interact with each other in a multiplicative way, and they follow these heavy tails distributions like the power law and like it seems to be the case of the choriocapillaries, as previously demonstrated by Dr. Spade. And an interesting property, and perhaps the most striking of the power laws, is that they obey a symmetry of scale invariance over a finite range of event sizes. And this scale invariance is much better demonstrated by the Hant ontology in comparison to my mathematical formulas. But the most important of it is that it enables us to study the organization using these box counting methods, and we can plot the organization in terms of fractal dimension and of the lacunarity of our image patterns if they follow this, this power law. And so these box counting methods enable us to get two new parameters for our OCT angiography images. The first one, the fractal analysis, that is a measure of the non-empty squares that are present in this image per square size, and it's a measure of the organization of our image pattern, and the lacunarity, that is the complement of the fractal analysis and gives us an idea of the homogeneity or the heterogeneity of the system. The more heterogeneous, the higher the fractal dimension, as Dr. Koskas has talked this morning. And so, with these works, we wanted to verify if we could quantify the characteristics of the flow voids, and if we could compare, using the fractal dimension, the fellow eyes of patients with neovascular AMD and patients with unhealthy choriocapillaries. And so to perform this, we compared two groups of patients. The first one were the fellow eyes of patients with NAMD. The second one was a control group. We excluded patients with shadowing effect on the choriocapillaries, systemic microvascular disorders. And to perform the image acquisition, we used the Triton OCT from Topcon, and we evaluated the choriocapillary slab. To perform the analysis of the voids, we used the protocols previously published. We binarized the images, the particles were analyzed using the analyzed particles commons of Fiji, and the distribution was studied using the R scripting language and a previously published power law package, and the fractal dimension and lacunarity analysis were performed using a MATLAB coding language. And so, about our results, first of all, we observed that the distribution of the flow voids closely resembles a power law distribution with advantage over the log normal and exponential distributions, and we could verify this when we performed the KAS test using the bootstrap procedure with very strong values for all the patients in our cohort. Here we have plot the differences in age, sex, and gender between the two groups, and in this table, we can see the mean differences in fractal dimension between NAMD fellow eyes and the control group, and we observe that the NAMD fellow eyes have a higher fractal dimension and a higher lacunarity compared to the control eye patients. These differences can also be observed using the box plot analysis, where we observe a higher median fractal dimension and median lacunarity between the NAMD fellow eye and the control group, and these differences stood even after we corrected for the age of the patients, and using this multivariable analysis, we also verified that age was correlated with a higher fractal dimension in our patients. And so to discuss a little bit our results, what we have concluded is that these box counting methods seem to be a good metric to put in evidence the differences in the organization between the choriocapillaries of NAMD fellow eyes and of control patients. And we found, through the fractal dimension, an organization typical of flow voids of larger regions and a more heterogeneous distribution in NAMD fellow eyes compared to the control group counterpart, and these differences have been described previously in recent papers using different methodologies. And so, despite some of the limitations of our work, it was just a pilot study, a proof of concept, as Dr. Glittenberg would say. In our opinion, we have strong evidence that these box counting metrics may be very useful in the future for quantification and characterization of blood flow characteristics in the choriocapillaries, and may provide us new OCT-A parameters that we may use on the routine clinical practice in the future for assessing of the organization and uniformity of the choriocapillaries. We thank your attention and we'd be glad to answer all your questions. Thank you.